Thank you very much. Livingstone, Member of Parliament, I would like to state that indeed the scheme perpetuated by the Patriotic Front here to divide this country on tribal lines is quite unfortunate and disheartening. For a long time, lived as one. For example, talking about myself, I was first elected as councillor on the MMD ticket in 2006, and I became deputy mayor of the city of Livingstone and subsequently a member of parliament. How else do you want to explain this victory? Because probably the people of Southern Cross are accommodated. They also want to live along by other people from other regions and the provinces. Livingstone, for example, they've had people from other tribes. Currently, we have Robert Wandila serving as Zambezi Ward Chancellor. Kumbuka from Eastern Province. We have Moses Simbaya from Northern Province serving as Malamba Ward Chancellor. We have Sheriff Bota serving as Dapa Central Ward Chancellor from Eastern Province. We also have Robert Chiresha serving as Kaliba Ward Chancellor from Northern Province. He sometimes even in November in council meetings, it's unfortunate that they have continued trying to gain political mileage by using ethnicity, which shouldn't be the case. And all well-meaning Zambians should condemn it with the context that it deserves. You see, when you look at other districts also, like Chomba, in a remote district, we have Mr. Sakala, who is a council in Kalongo Ward. We also have Stanley Sakala from Mazabuka, who was first elected as a councillor, and subsequently in 2011, he was elected as a mayor. What more people want? All this is because people of Southern Province are inclusive in terms of the way they would want to govern this country. For someone to state that the people of Southern Province are ungovernable, it's really sad for some of us who have chosen to settle in Southern Province. This person probably came and he was locked up in a room at the hotel or guest house and decided to issue those unfortunate statements, not knowing that even within the PF structures in Southern Province, there are all people from Northern Province and Eastern Province, meaning the locals have not been considered. Is this really showing the people of Zambia or telling the people of Zambia that PF is only for the Easterners and Bembas? It shouldn't be like that. We should embrace everybody. When you look at the issue of what we are talking about now, is that we are aware, all of us, that the president, Mr. Edgar Changwarungu, has the powers to stop this vice completely by whipping all those that have been uttering these statements, because for a long time now we've been hearing from top officials at party level, at executive level, being cabinet, ministers have been issuing these statements, divisive statements, but no word has come from the president. Meaning, if he remains mute, we shall take it that he is the one that is probably engineering tribal demands. So as to divide this country into and bring chaos in this country, of which it will be unfortunate that people may wish also to be reminded that when you look at what has been happening since independence, that the Choma Declaration, where the Tongas contributed enormously in terms of finances and human resource, it was a beacon of peace where we talked about condemning violence and political, you know, and tribal politics in Zambia so that we live as one Zambia, one nation. Let not these services be lip services. Let's walk the talk. Whatever we are saying is what we should be doing. So it's sad for some of us who, myself, I hail from the Eastern Province. My father is from Tengureni. My mother is from Chief Mafuda. It's really sad that each time that you open the paper, you see these tribal talks. You open the TV, that people are being disturbed by tribal remarks from either people from senior management, party, the highland of the PF, and also the government. So we want to urge the president that he can only issue today a word and everyone else will be able to toe the line. Thank you very much.